I want to hand the mic and the megaphone over to Ben Fractenberg and Emma Whitford, who are going to talk to you about what it's like to be in the firing line with Joe Ricketts.
Oh, don't worry, I can do that.
First of all, I would just like to thank everyone for showing up today and the outpouring of support that we've been shown. It's been incredible. You know, when we were really caught flat-footed when this happened. I was in court reporting on something, and I started to get all these frantic text messages. And went on the website to look at DNAinfo and realized that my life's work as a journalist is the only place I've worked since finishing grad school had just been eviscerated. And we should be clear that that is not just an attack on us. We have strong support from the community here. We'll be okay. We'll land on our feet. But this is an attack on millions of people throughout the country who depended on our reporting. And to then take down the work that journalists had done to hold people of power, powerful institutions to account, to take that down and eviscerate the public record lets people off the hook. And it is insulting to all the people in the communities across the country who depend on our reporting. It was a disgusting act, and it was an act of retaliation, and it's something that no one should stand for. But I think something that has happened out of this that's really important is that it started a national conversation. I don't think anyone, when they made a decision to shutter DNAinfo and Gothamist, so suddenly realized what an outpouring of support we'd have and how much press there would be around it and how people would start to talk about and call for the importance of local journalism throughout the country. And that's within our power. We don't need to feel like our careers, the information that we get, could suddenly be taken away because a powerful person gets angry at his worker standing up for their rights. It's within our power to create local journalism to support it. Thank you. And I want to introduce Emma Whitford, great reporter from Gothamist, who's going to talk about what we can do, because we need to talk about looking forward to the future, because that's what this is about.
Okay. Woo! All right, I've never used one of these. Can you guys hear me? All right. So I think we, more than anybody, know that long press conferences are really boring, so we'll keep it really short. We're really proud to be out here today, and the message that I want to get across to other shops who haven't organized yet, like, don't be afraid because of us. You know, we're really freaking sad, but we've also had an amazing, more than 48 hours, and I keep telling people, like, I feel the opposite of lonely. Like, this is a network. Local journalists look out for each other. There are still so many out there. And I would just encourage you to do what we did, and don't be afraid. I'll leave it there.